and started blaming Trump for Biden's horrible Afghanistan pullout. With Easter coming up, do people even know why we celebrate Easter? No, they don't. Also in the news, Joe Biden's minions are making excuses for him. Also in the news, the judge of the Trump case in New York threatens Trump and says that he has the right to waive Trump's right to show up in court. Is this overstepping his power? Let's find out. You're watching The Demetrius Arujo Show, and I'm your host, Demetrius Arujo. Without further ado, let's begin. Facts over tracks, isn't that spitting slow, spitting fast, I could roast, I could gas, think I'm okay at last, but I don't know if that can erase all the past. So, beginning with Easter, it is on Sunday, so I just wanted everybody to look at the info on religion. If you can ask people why we even celebrate Easter, all they will say is that rabbits break into your house and they leave gifts, just like Santa. But it's far more than that. We celebrate Jesus opening the gates of heaven and being resurrected and telling everybody that heaven is real. With this information, a lot of people begs the question, are people really losing religion or do people just not know? I say the former, because if you look at the trajectory of believers, more people are starting to believe in hell rather than heaven. Just look at what's on the mainstream TV. We have seen worshiping taking place, but no prayer. It's a sad, backwards world we live in. Also, according to CBS, people that believe in heaven are far way happier in their lives. This is just because they don't think that we just take a dirt nap when we pass away and let the bugs eat ourselves. But instead, they will go to heaven and get rewarded for living a dedicated life. With that being said, let's move on to a dozen takes. Okay, digging right into the first headline of the week, we actually have an article from Project Veritas. Now, I know that a lot of people do not like Project Veritas anymore because of what they do to James O'Keefe, but when we have a breaking story in front of our face, I'm not going to ignore it. And yes, I just completely disagree with how they treated Kevin. I completely disagree with how they treated James O'Keefe, yes. But we also have a story right here that a United States-based TikTok employee reveals a lot of coding shit very beneficial to China. Says DC team worked directly with the FBI to find locations and effort to take down wanted criminals like Andrew Tate. Bruce Sapp, a content moderator at TikTok, I'm sure, and this is his quote, not mine, I'm sure a lot of the coding shit is very beneficial to China. This is the undercover journalist. You have a train like a year with the FBI because things they do are more of like, I don't know if you've heard, but like Andrew Tate getting down in Romania. So like, it wouldn't be more of that shit. Like people who are over here on TikTok that are obviously wanted criminals working with the police, like helping them find their locations, like shit like that. So we can go on and on, but I think that I'm just gonna let him speak for himself.
The DC team, I was looking at their job descriptions. A lot of them work directly like with the FBI, and you have to train like a year with like FBI and there. Because like things they do are more of like, I don't know if you've heard, but like Andrew Tate getting taken down in Romania.
Yeah.
So like it would be more of that, like people who are on TikTok that are obviously wanted criminals working with the police, like helping them find like their locations, shit like that.
Like people in our government want to ban TikTok off of government officials' devices.
Right.
Why is that?
If I had to guess, it's because I'm sure a lot of that coding shit is still very beneficial to China.
I feel like I get the inside scoop with you.
A little bit.
A Project Veritas undercover journalist met with Bruce Sapp, a content moderator for TikTok. Amidst national concern over the social media app's effects on young children and connections to the Chinese Communist Party, Bruce tells our journalists about his own reservations with TikTok's policies and connection to the FBI.
So you're an employee of ByteDance.
ByteDance, Inc., yes.
What's the difference between that and TikTok?
ByteDance owns TikTok.
Okay, so do you like it?
It's a job. I don't know. I don't mind it.
Yeah.
There's a lot of shit I don't agree with that happens, but...
Like what?
Thank you. There's a lot of, trying to think of, like, the most legal way to say it. Not that I don't trust you, but in case it does come back out.
Okay. You can be open with me. Like, people in our government want to ban TikTok off of government officials' devices.
Right.
Why is that?
If I had to guess, it's because I'm sure a lot of that coding is still very beneficial to China.
And because of the whole China-America relationship, I'm sure it's something to do with that. The VC team? Yes. I was looking at their job descriptions.
What do you mean?
Like, a lot of them work directly, like, with the FBI, so you need, like, a certain amount of, like, train. Like, it's nuts. Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, because I applied to do global policy in DC. I didn't get the job, but... Like, seeing the job requirements, I knew I wasn't going to get it, but I was like, oh, let's see, throw my hat in the ring.
What are the job requirements?
It's like, you have to have, like, 2 years minimum of, like, law enforcement. You have to have, if we hire you on, you have to train, like, a year with, like, FBI and their because, like, things they do are more of, like, I don't know if you've heard, but, like, Andrew Tate getting taken down in Romania.
Yeah.
So, like, it would be more of that. Like, people who are on TikTok that are obviously wanted criminals, working with the police, like, helping them find, like, their locations, shit like that.
No, I don't take shit.